रिफ्लेक्शन, द लाइट इज कमिंग लाइक दिस एंड रिफ्लेक्टिंग ऑफ द मिरर लाइक दिस 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 हियर इज योर टॉर्च. द लॉ अबाउट रिफ्लेक्शन इज दैट द एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस इज इक्वल टू एंगल ऑफ रिफ्लेक्शन. सो व्हाट इज द एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस एंड व्हाट इज द एंगल ऑफ रिफ्लेक्शन? द एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस इज द एंगल एट विच द लाइट हिट्स द मिरर. नाउ यू माइट आस्क दैट वी कैन मेजर द एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस इन टू वेज, राइट, दिस एंड दिस. Why don't we measure the angle of incidence like this? This could be our angle of incidence, the angle with the mirror. The reason that we don't do this is because sometimes the mirrors are curved like this, okay? And then a light comes here and goes like this. Then it will become difficult to measure this angle, right? So what we do is, we draw a perpendicular line to this mirror and measure the angle of incidence like this. So what is the angle of incidence? The angle of incidence is the angle between the light and the normal drawn. This is a normal. Normal means a perpendicular line. The angle of incidence is the angle between the light and the normal to the mirror. So the angle of incidence is the angle between the incoming ray of light and the normal to the mirror. Similarly, what is the angle of reflection? The angle between the outgoing ray and the normal to the mirror. That's the angle of reflection. And the law of reflection is angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. Simple as that. So for example, if I gave another light like this, okay, now imagine this to be 20 degrees, then automatically the angle of reflection will also be, or this is not the angle of incidence by the way, imagine that this to be suppose 60 degrees, the angle of reflection will also be 60 degrees like this, okay? And if you give it at some higher angle like 70 degrees, the angle of reflection will also be 70 degrees. Properties of mirror image. When you see your image in the mirror, there are some properties which you have already noticed but you never gave a thought. The properties are, the image that you see, provided that it is a normal mirror, it doesn't magnify, the picture that you see is the same size as you are, okay? It doesn't show you as something bigger or smaller. You see yourself as the same size in the mirror. Same distance. If you move closer to the mirror, that image inside the mirror will also move closer to the mirror. So imagine that the mirror is in the middle. This is the real you and that's the reflection you, the virtual you. So if you move closer to the mirror, your picture, your virtual picture will also move closer to the mirror. If you touch your nose with the mirror, that picture will also touch its nose with the mirror. So you and your picture are always the same distance away from the mirror. That's what same distance means, in line. So imagine that here is a mirror, here's your mirror, and here you are standing. You won't see that your picture is over here. If you're standing here, your picture will be here. If you're standing here, your picture will be here. See, it is in the same straight line. So this is what in line means.